Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding the lead editorial. Now this lead editorial is important from GES mains paper 3, plus this is also important for geography and economics and public administration and political science optional students. Now what is this editorial about? Now in order to understand this, we will go in the background, because background will give us an idea about the current fiscal policies that the government is mulling about. Now when it comes to any country, it is important that it must have fiscal prudence. Now what is meant by fiscal prudence? Now fiscal prudence means that a country's fiscal setup should be optimum. Now what is meant by optimum? It means that the country should not be in lot of debt. A country should be spending the amount in relationship with what its earnings are. It means that the spending should not be more than your earnings. There should not be a huge gap. Now this huge gap in economics is calculated by a concept called as fiscal deficit. Now we have numerous other type of deficits. We have the primary deficit, we have the monetized deficit, we have the revenue deficit, we have the fiscal deficit. Now all these deficits give an idea about how much the sovereign government is spending more in comparison to the earnings. Now when it comes to India, because there is a lot of demand from the government, because India is a developing nation, we have demand for the development of education, we have demand for the development of the health, we have demand for the development of infrastructure. So in order to assure development in all these realms, it is important that the government should be spending more. But the government should not actually puncture the threshold level. The threshold level means the threshold of optimum spending in comparison to the revenue that the government is generating. Now because government, they have a tendency to spend more, so in order to keep a tab, to keep a limit, fixed limit of how much the government should be spending, the government in the past, in 2007 and 2008, it had come out with FRBM Act, Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act. It came out in year 2004, it was implemented in year 2005. The first limit was set up in for the year 2007 and 2008. So its practical implementation was for year 2007 and 2008. Now in this specific year, the target was fixed that the fiscal deficit of the government should fall in the bracket of ranging 3 to 3.5, and the revenue deficit should be reducing to 0% in 2008 and 2009. But 2008, what we witnessed was the global economic crisis. Now in the global economic crisis that we had, the government, in order to support the economy, had to spend more. So the targets, the standard of this fiscal prudence that the government was supposed to achieve, they were not taken into consideration. There were disregard of the standards set up by FRBM Act, fiscal responsibility. That means you need to be fiscally responsible, and budget management act, and manage your budget in a way so that you are fiscally responsible. That was the intention of that particular act. But of late, again, as the economy is normalizing, as the clouds of uncertainty, the global economic atmosphere, they're actually giving signals of normalcy, it is important that the economy should be again guided by such type of standards. Now why it is important to have such type of standards? That's another important area to understand. Now if the economy will not be guided by the fiscal responsibility and the budget management acts, like type of legislations, in that case there is a danger that the government might end up spending lot of money. And in that case, the fiscal health of the nation will deteriorate. And the credit rating agencies and the rating agencies, they will come out with the poor rating for a nation like India. And if there will be poor rating for a nation like India, the foreigners, the corporate sector in the foreign, they will feel worry to spend and invest in India. Because if your sovereign is weak, it means there are chances that your investment might face a lot of danger. So you don't invest in such countries. So it is important for a country like India to have good fiscal prudence laws. And for that, government had set up an NK Singh committee. Now this NK Singh committee had recommended that along with focusing on the fiscal deficit, government must focus on debt to GDP ratio. So this is the new thing that has been introduced. It's on the anvil that the government will be implementing debt to the GDP ratio of 60%, of which 38.7% should be the debt of the center and 20% should be the debt of the states. So along with this, NK Singh committee has also recommended another important thing. Now that is about setting up a fiscal council. The government, if it needs to aberrate, if it needs to veer away from the standard, जो भी स्टैंडर्ड सेटअप किया है हमने फिस्कल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी एंड बजट मैनेजमेंट एक्ट में, अगर उससे आपने एबरेट होना है, अगर उससे आपने चेंज होना है, सो इन दैट केस इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट द गवर्नमेंट शुड ऑल्सो बी अकाउंटेबल टू सम सॉर्ट ऑफ बॉडी दैट मेंटेन्स अकाउंटेबिलिटी एंड कंट्रोल ओवर इट. एंड फॉर दिस एनके सिंह कमेटी हैज रिकमेंडेड दैट द फिस्कल काउंसिल शुड बी सेट अप. नाउ द थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग from this NK Singh committee's recommendation is that the government should be given leeway and the freedom in order to aberrate and veer from the standards that would be set up under the new Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act, the new act. But the problem here lies in, abhi jo aaj ka editorial hai, isme badi important problem ko analyze kiya gaya hai. हमारे पास सेंटर का फिस्कल प्रूडेंस है, हमारे पास स्टेट का फिस्कल प्रूडेंस है. नाउ अगर सेंटर का देखा जाए फिस्कल प्रूडेंस, तो सेंटर बहुत सोच समझ के पैसे खर्च करता है. बट अगर स्टेट्स का देखा जाए और स्टेट्स की इकोनॉमिक हेल्थ को एनालाइज किया जाए, उनकी फिस्कल बैलेंस को एनालाइज किया जाए, तो स्टेट्स का जो फिस्कल सिनारियो है वो काफ़ी ज़्यादा खराब है इन कंपैरिजन टू सेंटर. सो इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट दैट द स्टेट शुड नॉट बी रिसोर्टिंग टू पॉपुलिस्टिक मेजर्स. जो लोग चाहते हैं कि ये कर दो वो कर दो, लाइक लोन वेवर कर दीजिए आप, उदय उज्ज्वल डिस्कॉम एंड अश्योरेंस योजना है, उसमें पूरे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सेक्टर को, पावर जनरेशन को आप क्या कर रहे हो, सब्सिडाइज करने की कोशिश कर रहे हो, रेदर देन रेक्टिफाइंग द मेन प्रॉब्लम, ट्रांसमिशन एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन प्रॉब्लम इन द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सेक्टर, इन द पावर जनरेशन सेक्टर. व्हाट यू आर ट्राइंग टू डू इज यू आर जस्ट ट्राइंग टू tinker with the minor changes in the sector by making it a burden on the states in the form of Ujjwal DISCOM Assurance Yojana. So such kind of policies actually create a lot of burden on the states, and this becomes one of the reason why a country like India fails to achieve fiscal prudence. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact us at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.